Welcome back to Sailing Ruby Rose from the Saigon Shipyard. I am here at lunchtime, not in the morning. Why am I here at lunchtime? Because this afternoon they are moving this boat outside, and they are moving it outside so that they can step the mast tomorrow, which means we have a mast and then we're going to standing rigging, running rigging, sails, then sailing. Super exciting. Keep watching this one. It's epic. So we have about 10 minutes to run before the lunch break ends, and I do want to take a walk around the boat because a lot is happening here. One thing that I have noticed, mousing lines. I love mousing lines. I love mousing lines, and I was very, very adept at doing them on Ruby Rose. But because we're getting a stepping tomorrow, everything has been moused. What do I mean by mousing lines? Look at this good stuff. Everything labeled, moused. We are gonna have running rigging on this boat very, very, very soon. Everything closes for Tet in about 5 days' time. So this will be happening when we get back from Tet, because Tet, I think everything closes for a week. Now that everything is moused, everything is set up and protected to move out. So today and this afternoon, we're gonna see that. What else have we got to see? Let's take a look in these lockers. I told you I don't show you everything in here. The steps going down into the locker for the gas locker, I don't think we've done much with here, and I'm gonna try and get down here without killing myself. But again, we talked very, very in depth about two steps down, ergonomically able to get in without causing too many problems. So here I am inside the locker. I wanted to talk you through it all. We've done a few bits about this, and yes, it's a locker, but talking about practicality of lockers, moving through two-part locker, this actually has a section which you can close off, two steps going down, and then moving into here, gas locker, everything there, that, solenoid. All the plumbing hosing, everything down there, all sorted out, super, super impressive. I can climb out through my two steps. Oh, let's just slide myself across here. Oh. Step back out again. So, foredeck, everything ready, everything moused. I'm gonna show you everything. I've obviously done a lot of work in mousing all these lines. If I show you the clutches here, we now have clutches in place, everything moused, all the buttons for the winches, all done here. We also have the windlass control, the throttles. Nice. Engine start, engine stop. We're getting there. We are getting there. And so at the end of the afternoon break, you may hear a bell in a minute. There was a meeting about half an hour ago when management decided how they were going to move these boats out safely. And then what's going to happen now? This boat, hull number one, will be moved out into the space behind us. And tomorrow morning, they are going to step the mast. So tomorrow morning, you're going to see the mast on. You are going to see the standing rigging put on, and then over the coming days, boom, forestay, sails, everything, we will have a sailing boat. Then there'll be final fit out, and then we're going sailing. We are getting there. We are really getting there. Stay tuned for this. It's going to be pretty exciting. I think the team are quite stressed because they've got to move all this, but it's going to be amazing. Typical, the skies have just opened. This is so unseasonal, rain at this time of year. But anyway, Mr. Khan, who you may have seen from previous videos, is just getting the whole team together, the whole team to just organize how they're going to shift this boat. It's all done manually. There's no like tractors involved. They're just going to literally push it forward, get a little bit of clearance so that tomorrow morning that mast is going to go on. So yeah, everyone's taking their positions. Pretty exciting, not? Khan says he's not stressed, but I would be. They're potentially attaching some pretty rugged straps to the two forklifts, and they're going to just drag the whole thing. Drag everything away. So this guy here is literally just lifting that up. So the first boat, this is the first time this boat has seen the sun. It's the first time in a year that this hull has actually left the yard, except for when I move yards. But nonetheless, it is the first time that this boat has seen the sun, and she looks beautiful. Wow. So this is pretty intense. Like, they've moved the boat, the kind of like area where the mast will be stepped is now exposed. There's complete height there, and that means that tomorrow morning when I come back at an ungodly hour, they will be putting that mast on. Behind me, hole one. To the right of me, the mast for hole one. To the left of me, the crane for the mast for hole one. So, mast. We went through the mast for the 1600 with Mike before, but actually now we can see that we've got the whole mast for the 1370 in its beauty, in its glory. Everything moused through, ready to go on. Crane driver is cleaning his windows. It is 8 o'clock in the morning. I've been here for an hour. Lucas, you are going to get my boot up your ass because you told me 7:30 and he's still lying around in his bed. Oh, there he is. What time did you call this, you 7:30. You little head. How you doing? You all right? All right, bastard. I'll let you get on with your day. Yeah. We'll be back in a bit. My Argentinian friend is very laid back with his timekeeping. Anyway, so where was I? Yeah, mast on the 1370. Everything in place, crane in place. Actually, despite Lucas being a little bit lackadaisical with his ability to turn up at 7:30 in the morning, everything is going like clockwork. So thank you to the Vietnamese staff and to James and to Mr. Khan for being here at 7:30. I will continue to watch this and film this amazing process, because by the end of today, you are going to have a boat which is just about ready to sail. This is going to be pretty cool. So 20 minutes later, mast, crane, boat. Lucas has just been checking the strops. Then we'll get this whole thing lifted up, put on the boat. Yeah, milestone complete. Like, it's pretty tense. It is pretty tense. But every part of this team seem pretty aware of what their job roles are. Okay, so the crane operator's got the strops on. You can see behind me. And yeah, they'll start lifting this now. It's gonna be pretty intense. Got a couple of drones going, got the camera going. Keep watching.
And so finally, the workers and the crane operator are ready to raise the mast. Eventually the mast goes up. The workers are all on standby, holding the shrouds. Lucas is orchestrating all this to make sure that nothing binds, that there is no tangles, that nothing actually aggravates the lift. Finally, with the mast in place, they use the spinnaker halyards, tie bowlines, just to kind of keep everything upright, keep everything straight. After that, the mast is very, very gently, with all the electronics and all the cabling, slowly fed through into the deck. Everything is lowered in place. And now the work of actually stepping and getting the shrouds attached starts.
So there we are. Hull one, mast one. Amazing. I hope you enjoyed this episode. We actually have a functioning boat. Tomorrow the boom, then the sails, then we go to sea trials. We're getting so, so close. So that's boat one moved. Hull one over there. Hull two, also known as Ruby Rose 2, gonna be moved up. Everything is being shuffled up for the next and final stage of production. Lucas is over there, not sure. Lucas, are you actually working? MLK? You want to come and say hello to everyone? Seriously, look at this beautiful Argentinian man. Anyway. Lucas, say goodbye to people. Say goodbye to everyone.
Goodbye.
We'll see you next week. Take care. I'm going to go for a drink with this one. So did you enjoy that? Pretty damn stressful, no? Just seeing that all taking place. If you enjoyed this episode, we'll be back next week. Give us a like, give us a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. And I will see you all next week. Bye-bye.